Click on one of the buttons below to view an animation of that substance dissolving in water.
Let's add a small amount of table salt, sodium chloride, to water. As you know, sodium chloride dissolves in water. Click on the zoom button to view sodium chloride dissolving in water on a microscopic scale. Polar water molecules interact with the positive and negative ions of a salt. The positive ends of the water molecules are attracted to the negative chloride ions. The negative ends of the water molecules are attracted to the positive sodium ions. This interaction between water and the salt ions causes a salt to break apart or dissolve in water.
Let's add a small amount of methanol, CH3OH, to water. Methanol dissolves in water. Click on the zoom in button to view methanol dissolving in water on a microscopic scale. Methanol molecules contain a polar OH group. The oxygen has a partial negative charge and the hydrogen has a partial positive charge. This charge separation is called a dipole. Methanol molecules are attracted to each other through the interaction of the dipole of one molecule with the dipole of another molecule. Water is also polar, and the dipole of water will interact with the dipole of methanol. The attractions between water molecules and a methanol molecule will break the attractions between methanol molecules, causing methanol to dissolve in water. Note that upon dissolving, the covalent methanol molecules remain intact. Compare this to the dissolution of an ionic compound such as sodium chloride, NaCl, which breaks apart into its component ions in water.